Welcome to you all. Welcome to my channel, Mechanical Engineering Concept. Today, now I am going to discuss about coupling. What is the coupling in machine design? So first we need to discuss what is the basic definition of coupling. A coupling can be defined as a mechanical device that permanently joins two rotating shafts to each other. So, with this definition, we can understand that a coupling is the element, mechanical element or machine element, which is used to connect two shafts. So, first question arises, why we need to connect two shafts? So, the basic reason behind this is that because if we need to connect two ends to transmit power with respect to shaft, so we cannot design a longer length of shaft because due to load transmission, due to torque and bending, the component will shear out. So the component will fail due to shearing. So we need to design two separate shaft for input and output purpose, and with the help of couple or with the help of coupling element, we can connect the input and output shaft. So here in this diagram, we can see that this is the shaft in which there is a keyway in which we can fit the key by which this left hand coupling will hold that shaft, and on the other hand, same type of shaft is used to fit it in the right hand of a coupling with respect to key, square or rectangular key. This hole are used to connect this to couple to transmit power, which is locked with respect to nut bolt arrangement. This couple, this left hand and right hand couple, is used to connect input and output shaft to transmit power. So now we need to discuss what is the basic function of coupling. So the coupling element should connect or align two shafts. So first major application of major function of coupling should be it should have to connect two shaft and should have to align two shaft in axis of rotation, so the input shaft can transmit power with respect to coupling help to output shaft. Okay, so first point is that. Second point, it should prevent shock loading. It means that suppose input shaft is rotating with respect to speed n, whatever the speed, 200 rpm, 300 rpm, or with respect to torque transmitted 100 Nm, or so and so forth. So the output shaft should take that speed uniformly, slowly, gradually. The speed of output shaft should have to increase. If suppose the output shaft will attain that input shaft speed suddenly, then there is a chance of output shaft fail due to shear or due to sudden load increase. So the coupling should have to prevent the shock loading. Third point is there should be not too loss of power in a coupling. Smooth transmission is a main important aspect of coupling. So with that we can say that the power should not be lost from input to output of transmission. And last point is the torque should be smoothly transmitted. As I told you earlier in the second point, prevention of shock loading means suppose L1 is the speed of L1 is the speed of input shaft, suppose it is 200 rpm, so the output shaft should take that speed in a gradual way, gradual increase way, increase manner, so that it cannot, it should not fail in that load or increase of load output shaft, so the torque transmission should be smooth. Next point is that what are the different types of coupling? So the basically we can divide coupling in a two major categories. First one is the rigid coupling, second one is the flexible coupling. Rigid coupling means the couple will rigidly connected with each other, and flexible coupling means the couple can move in a transverse direction along the axis of rotation. But in rigid coupling, component will only rotate in that in its axis of rotation, but in flexible coupling, the component will can rotate about its own axis or also can bend along its axis of rotation. So the rigid coupling can be divided into three parts. First one is the sleeve or muff coupling. Second one is the clamp or compression coupling, and last one is the flange coupling. Flexible coupling divided can be also two, three parts. First one is the bush pin coupling, universal coupling, and last one is the hole hand coupling. I will discuss each of them in upcoming further videos, which is to design procedure, how to calculate, how to design the sleeve coupling or muff coupling, clamp or compression coupling, flange coupling, or different types of flexible coupling, with respect to each dimension calculation, with respect to failure criteria, and what are the different components and different elements which are coming in this flexible and rigid coupling and their types. So I hope you like this video. Please, if you like this video, then please press the like button, and please kindly subscribe my channel, and kindly press bell icon adjacent to subscription button to get further notification of my channel for upcoming videos. If you have any query, then please share in my comment box below the video. Thank you.